Hi, it's day 15 and we are dealing with O, alphabet O. Okay, I had a very obvious choice from my own life, Olympic calm. That's not what I'm going to present today, but those of you who are interested in English, in the English language, go and find out what's Olympic calm. It has nothing to do with the sports arena that the Olympic Games offer. No, Olympic calm is something else and it is much needed in my life. In fact, just 2 minutes before shooting this video, I was hopping and jumping all around in anger about something. So I thought I should talk about Olympic calm. Okay, but now I am reminding myself that this video is being watched by young law students and I need to make it measurable, I need to make it meaningful. So O for opportunity. Okay, and here comes the spiel. Here comes the irreverent part of me, which is much hated around this part of the world because I'm so irreverent about things. Opportunity. If your papa is not a lawyer, and mama is not a lawyer, and mama is not a lawyer, and chacha is not a lawyer, and grandfather is not a lawyer, like in my case, this won't come easy in your life. For those of you who are blessed to be born in a family of law, of lawyers, you will not know the value of this, but I'll do a separate video on what you need to do with that opportunity. But this is presuming you do not have any background in law. In the sense, neither your parents nor your near relatives are lawyers, or if they are, they are not in a position to offer you a job, or you're not willing to take up a job. In that case, this will be few and far between. Now, India is a very dynastic society, isn't it? Somebody is an actor, so his son is an actor. His grandson is an actor. Or daughter is an actor, granddaughter is an actor, and that's very dynastic. Almost, you know, it's just a small crowd. So also with politics, somebody was a chief minister of some state, the son will be the chief minister of that state, the grandson will be in politics. So on and so forth. Same with law. In India, it's a very small and rigid community where it's not easy to break in. Now, I'm not saying you'll not get a job. You will get a job, but breaking in to the inner circle of those hallowed aristocratic blue-blooded law firms is not going to be easy. And you know what? You don't need to be there. You can do all this by yourself. Take heart. It's not going to be easy, but here are the few things that you can do immediately. And this is all under the section network. You need to network like crazy, like there's no tomorrow. And how do you do that? First step of networking. Is this visible or you want to come closer? It's visible. Number one, join Chambers of Commerce. As many as you can. If you're a student, I think there are student discounts applicable. Indo-German Chamber of Commerce, highly recommended. Indo-Japanese Chamber of Commerce, highly recommended. Keep away from the Indo-American Chamber of Commerce, it's too crowded. Look at these small countries that have very little representation in India. Indo-Italian Chamber of Commerce, recommended. Why am I asking you to do this? Because you will meet lots of members there and you will have many opportunities to network. You understand very well that lawyers in India are not allowed to advertise. So how are you going to generate business over a period of time? By networking. And one of the most effective ways is to join Chambers of Commerce. Another way to network, look at this organization called BNI. B for Bombay, N for Nancy, I for India. BNI. It stands for something. Can somebody check it up? It's a US-based organization. I quite like their networking activities. I've been there a couple of times. Beautiful. I think they are all over India, all over the world. Highly recommended. So, you have Chamber of Commerce, you have BNI. Where else can you network? There are many local chambers of commerce. Yeah, many local in your area, there will be some Chamber of Commerce and Industry.
Business Network International.
Business Network International is what BNI is. So point number one, network like crazy. Spend some money. There is an annual membership fees that is to be paid. Pay it and show up at all their events. Carry your cards with you. You never know, you can strike a conversation with somebody that needs your services. Don't worry how young you are or inexperienced you are. You will gather it. Alright, that's how you create an opportunity for yourself. Point number two, and this is something very interesting. Write a newsletter, how about that? It's free, it's easy. Check out this website called Substack. Substack.com. And there's another, I think, called Review, R-E-V-U-E. These are two newsletter companies. You can just quickly start a newsletter free of cost, provided you keep writing every day. Right? Add your whoever, add your family, add your members, and over a period of time, keep adding. Now that network connected. The Chamber of Commerce, where you go, you get a card, take that person's permission, add that email ID into the newsletter. And write this newsletter at least once in 15 days. How about that? Choose an authority, choose a subject. You want to do something on shipping and maritime law, you're not an expert, no problem, give them maritime news. You want to be a family lawyer, there's lots of news. Your neighbors are fighting all the time. So you'll find that news very easy to come by. So by writing a newsletter and sustaining it for several months and years, you're creating an opportunity for yourself. What are the other ways to create that opportunity for yourself? Let's examine. This is something that was advised to me by a retired judge of Allahabad High Court, who I hold in very high esteem. He had told me this. Teach in law schools. How about that? If you're not a student, if you're a young lawyer, you've just graduated, doesn't matter. Go and teach in law schools. Even, in fact, you can go and teach in MBA institutes also. There's a close connection between management degree and law degree, to the extent that there are few subjects that deal with law. Teach in a law school. Your law students will become your brand ambassadors. Always about opportunity. And now, let's understand how you measure it. Supposing you're watching this video today, and 30 days from now, you go and set an alarm for yourself, and you can do that on Google Calendar, and the title of that alarm should be Review of O for Opportunity. In 30 days, if you have not joined a single Chamber of Commerce, if you have not attended a single BNI meeting, if you have not gone to Substack and started your own newsletter, you should get the hell out of bootcamp. Because you're not going to go anywhere, right? It means you don't come from a lawyer's family. You're doing nothing to create an opportunity for yourself. All right, you're going to be alone, and nobody is going to knock at your door and flood you with opportunities. That's not going to happen. You'll have to create it yourself. I would recommend that you join 4 Chambers of Commerce. Check out FICCI. What's FICCI? Now somebody will troll me saying, hey you idiot, we know what is FICCI. Listen, I'm not talking to people who have chips on the shoulder. I'm talking to somebody sitting in a remote part of this country, and I'm telling you, you need to know what is FICCI. Become a member of FICCI, become a member of SOCAM. And the way I tell you is to shake you up off your lethargy, make you feel bad. Alright, that's my purpose. Those of you already know FICCI, okay, stop trolling me and go and get a membership of FICCI. How about that? Good. Well, we are on O now. Measure yourself in 1 month. What have you done to increase your opportunities? I have already covered what else you can do. Show up at your neighbor's child's birthday and give a speech. Show up in your building society meetings and all those, you know, uncles sitting there, okay, as if they own the entire society. Okay, take notes and guide them. But uncle, you cannot do this. Uncle, you cannot do that. For example, there is an uncle in my society. Imagine, he must be old for me to call him uncle. He was opining that pets should not be allowed to use the lift. How can they use the lift? And I told him, I think there is somebody who's already taken care of this, Justice Radhakrishnan, in a beautiful order from the Bombay High Court, where pets is clearly ordained will use the lifts. Okay, if a pet is living on the 15th floor, there is no need for the poor pet to climb 15 floors. Right? A pet is like a son, at least to me. Right? And my son, who's a pet, may be better than a human son, who may be worse than a pig. Alright, so if that pig can use a lift, okay, my son can use a lift. Only those who own pets will understand the emotion attached behind that pet. So, as a lawyer, if you like pets, okay, you can bring him up to speed about the laws of the land. And as a lawyer, if you don't like pets, okay, don't take a wrong stand of stopping a Labrador from using the pet, from using the lift. Alright, tomorrow then back to alphabet P. In fact, I'm going to do it right now. We are on day 16, just 10 days away for your graduation. How about that? You know, I'll just dwell on this for a minute. 10 days away from completing a boot camp. Okay. The end of that journey. But again, I'm prodding you. We are on day 16. Where is your progress? Neha, where have you reached on Ford County? And where have you reached on legal confidential? Hamza had written to me that he's reading Constitution. Right? If I remember well. I don't know what the rest of you guys are even reading. I don't even know whether you guys are buying books. You know, there's so many interviews that I've conducted here for junior advocates, and in the CV it's written hobby reading. So I get all excited and I ask them, who's your favorite author?
Gulliver Travels. None.
Yeah, somebody even actually told me Gulliver Travels is, I felt it's a very cute answer. But anyway, most of the lawyers say, we read newspapers. Which one? Times of India. Okay. Basically, what they mean to say is when the newspaper comes to their house, when Papa is reading it, he peeps from behind and he reads 2-3 news articles. Okay. Have you ever read the Mint launch on Saturday? Do you know you can subscribe to the Washington Post? Did you know you can subscribe to the New York Times? Then you can say your hobby is reading newspapers because you're reading newspapers. When in, you know, in the CV, you have to write reading because it makes you look intellectual. Right. Now you're reading what? You're reading nothing, so newspaper. I had this one, anyway. I don't want to get trolled. I can give lots of such examples. So, books, you're not reading. Compose, C for compose. I don't see anything. Nobody has sent me anything to read. Except Sejal, Latif, Astha. Elocution. Astha is the only girl who sends me a video of her own elocution every day. What's happening to the rest of you guys? Huh? Do's and don'ts you don't have. iTime, yes, iPhone time you're spending a lot. What a pity. See you tomorrow. I'm just 10 days away from doing this. Okay, I'd like to get through with it quickly. So, P for the precise alphabet about which I'm leaving off from here and going to pick up in the next video. I'm talking about something which stands for P in the next video. Bye.